Hello, I am Dr. Nitin Nema with another interesting and learning episode of BPharm on the important unit of thyroid and anti-thyroid drugs, which is very important unit of the section of BPharm 7 SAM Pharmacology 3. Module 1, Introduction, Basic Anatomy. The thyroid gland is a butterfly-shaped endocrine gland that is normally located in the lower front of the neck. The thyroid's job is to make thyroid hormones, which are secreted into the blood and then carried to every tissue in the body. Thyroid hormone helps the body use energy, stay warm, and keep the brain, heart, muscles, and other organs working as they should. Anatomy of thyroid gland. The thyroid secretes following hormones. First, iodine containing amino acids are important for growth, development and mechanism, and these are triiodothyronine, tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine. Next, calcitonin is important in the regulation of calcium level. Module 2, Biosynthesis, Transport and Peripheral Metabolism of Thyroid Hormones. Iodine necessary for the synthesis of T3 and T4, which is derived from food or iodine supplements. Iodine uptake is an active process. Once taken up by the thyroid gland, iodine undergoes a series of enzymatic reactions that convert it into active hormone. The first step is the transport of the iodine into the gland by intrinsic follicle cell basement membrane protein called sodium iodine symporter. Iodide is oxidized by thyroid peroxidase to iodine. Iodination of tyrosine residues with the thyroglobulin molecule to form monoiodotyrosine and diiodotyrosine. This process is called iodide organification. Thyroidal peroxidase is transiently blocked by high levels of intrathyroidal iodide and thioamide drugs. Two molecules of DIT combine with the thyroglobulin to form L-thyroxine. One molecule of MIT and one molecule of DIT combine to form T3. T4, T3, MIT and DIT are released from thyroglobulin by exocytosis and proteolysis of thyroglobulin. The DIT and MIT are deiodinated within the gland and the iodine is reutilized. This process of proteolysis is blocked by high levels of intrathyroidal iodide. The ratio of T4 to T3 within thyroglobulin is 5:1, so that most of the hormone released is thyroxine. Most of circulating T3 in the blood is derived from peripheral metabolism of thyroxine. Transport, peripheral metabolism and control of thyroid function. Transport. T3 and T4 in the plasma are reversibly bound to thyroxine binding globulin, a transport protein in the blood. Peripheral metabolism. The primary pathway of peripheral metabolism is deiodination. Deiodination of T4 may occur by monoiodination of the outer ring producing triiodothyronine. Alternatively, deiodination of the inner ring produces triiodothyronine, which is inactive. Drugs such as Epodate, beta blockers, and corticosteroids and severe illness or starvation inhibit the 5-deiodinase necessary for the conversion of T4 to T3, resulting in low T3 and high RT3. Control of thyroid function. Hypothalamic cells secrete thyrotropin-releasing hormone into the capillaries of the pituitary portal system. TRH stimulates the synthesis and release of thyroid-stimulating hormone. TSH stimulates an adenylyl cyclase-mediated mechanism in the thyroid gland to increase the synthesis and release of T4 and T3. T4 and T3 act in a negative feedback fashion to block the action of TRH on the pituitary gland and on the hypothalamus to inhibit the synthesis and release of TRH. In Graves' disease, lymphocytes secrete a TSH receptor stimulating antibody which binds to the TSH receptor. The thyroid gland also regulates its uptake of iodide and thyroid hormone synthesis by intrathyroidal mechanisms that are independent of TSH. These mechanisms primarily related to the level of iodine in the blood. High concentration of iodide inhibits iodide organification and effect that is useful in the treatment of thyroid disease. Inadequate iodine intake results in diffuse enlargement of the thyroid goiter. Module 4, Mechanism of Action of T4 and T3 and Effect of Thyroid Hormone. First, T3 is 10 times more potent than T4, and since T4 is converted to T3 in target cells, the liver and kidneys, most of the effect of circulating T4 is probably due to T3. Second, thyroid hormone binds to receptors in the nucleus that control the expression of genes responsible for many metabolic processes. These receptors, when activated by T3, bind to DNA response elements and control synthesis of RNA, which codes for specific proteins that mediate the action of thyroid hormones. The proteins synthesized differ depending on the tissue involved. These proteins include sodium-potassium ATPase, a specific contractile protein in smooth muscles and the heart, enzymes involved in lipid metabolism, important developmental components in the brain. Effects of thyroid hormone. First, include normal growth and development of nervous, skeletal, reproductive systems and control of metabolism of fat, proteins and also metabolism of drugs. Second, thyroid deprivation in early life results in irreversible mental retardation and dwarfism, congenital cretinism. Thyroid hyperactivity results in thyrotoxicosis. Conversely, a decrease in thyroid activity results in hypothyroidism. Module 5. Hypothyroidism. The presence of hypothyroidism is about 2%, and this is 10 times more common in women. There are two main causes of hypothyroidism, namely autoimmunity and, as a side effect, of treatment for an overactive thyroid or for thyroid cancer. In autoimmune thyroid diseases, the thyroid cells are destroyed by white blood cells which attack the thyroid. Autoimmune thyroid disease is usually accompanied by the presence of thyroid peroxidase, autoantibodies which can be detected in the blood and are therefore a useful tool for diagnosis in patients who have an overactive thyroid or thyroid cancer. Treatment may consist of surgery or radioiodine, both of which destroy the diseased gland, but inevitably result in a significant proportion of patients developing hypothyroidism. Together, these two types of hypothyroidism account for well over 90% of all cases. Rarer causes include inflammatory responses in the thyroid, abnormal thyroid development in fetus, and genetic defects in thyroid function, leading to congenital hypothyroidism, which should usually be picked up during neonatal screening. Iodine deficiency is still a common cause of hypothyroidism in some parts of the world. Common complaints include fatigue and lethargy, cold sensitivity, dry skin, lifeless hair, impaired concentration and memory, increased weight with poor appetite and constipation, hoarse voice, tingling of hands, heavy and later absent periods, deafness and joint aches, impaired mental state or depression. Signs include slow movement, myxedema, facies, in which the face looks puffy due to the accumulation of subcutaneous fluid, cool dry skin, slow pulse rate, thinning of the hair including the eyebrows, slow tendon reflex relaxation time, slow pulse rate and hoarse voice. The thyroid may be enlarged in some patients due to accumulation of lymphocytes, but in others the thyroid is destroyed by the time of diagnosis and there is no goiter. Treatment of hypothyroidism. Thyroxine is the current standard thyroid hormone replacement recommended. This is the standard treatment for thyroid hormone deficiency. It has a half-life of 7 days and is readily converted into triiodothyronine by a process called peripheral deiodination in the body's tissue. Thyroxine supplementation therapy is recommended to be administered as a single daily dose, half an hour to 1 hour prior to breakfast. A minimum gap of 4 hours should be maintained between administration of thyroxine and drugs that are known to interfere with its absorption. Table 1. Management of hypothyroidism. First, healthy adult patients with hypothyroidism. Thyroxine treatment require thyroid hormone replacement in a dosage of 1.7 microgram per kg per day. Second, if patient is elderly children, then thyroxine treatment 1 microgram per kg per day. Third, if patient is young patient without risk factors for cardiovascular disease, the treatment is levothyroxine therapy should be started at a dosage of 0.075 mg per day and should be titrated against increasing serum TSH levels with small gradual increments. Fourth, in patient at risk for the cardiovascular, thyroxine treatment require thyroid hormone replacement therapy should be started at a dosage of 0.025 mg per day which should be gradually increased by 0.025 to 0.050 milligram every 4 hours to 6 weeks until TSH levels are normalized. Module 6. Hyperthyroidism. Hyperthyroidism develops when the body is exposed to excessive amounts of thyroid hormone. This disorder occurs in almost 1% of total population and affects women 5 to 10 times more often than men. In its mildest form, hyperthyroidism may not cause recognizable symptoms. More often, however, the symptoms are discomforting, disabling, or even life-threatening. When hyperthyroidism develops, a goiter enlargement of the thyroid is usually present and may be associated with some or many of the following features. Fast heart rate, often more than 100 beats per minute. Anxious, irritable, argumentative, trembling hands, weight loss despite eating the same amount or even more than usual, intolerance of warm temperatures and increased likelihood to perspire, loss of scalp hair, tendency of fingernails to separate from the nail bed, muscle weakness, especially of the upper arms and thighs, loose and frequent bowel movements, smooth skin, change in menstrual pattern, increased likelihood for miscarriage, prominent stare of the eyes, protrusion of the eyes with or without double vision, irregular heart rhythm, especially in patient older than 60 years of age, accelerated loss of calcium from bones, which increases the risk of osteoporosis and fractures. Treatment of hyperthyroidism. Beta blockers are a group of drugs that tend to improve some of the symptoms and manifestations of hyperthyroidism. In particular, they can improve palpitations, slow the heart down, and improve tremor. They have no effect on curing the thyroid overactivity, but do make many people feel better. Beta blockers should not be taken if the patient has asthma or a wheezy chest. Antithyroid drugs, carbimazole and propylthiouracil, are antithyroid drugs that are effective in reducing the production of thyroid hormones in the majority of people with hyperthyroidism. In people with Graves' disease, treatment with one of these drugs for between 6 months and 2 years results in a long-term remission in around half of patients. Once the drug is stopped, both drugs have the common side effects of rash and joint pains, and more rarely a serious reduction in the circulating white blood cells may occur during treatment. The dosage of these antithyroid drugs can either be adjusted every 6 to 8 weeks according to thyroid hormone levels in the blood. To keep the person's thyroid hormone levels in the normal range or kept at a fixed higher dose and levothyroxine replacement added to maintain normal thyroid hormone levels. In nodular hyperthyroidism, antithyroid drugs do not result in cure, just a temporary reduction in thyroid hormone levels. A more permanent solution is often sought, called a definitive treatment. Radioiodine रेडियो आयोडीन इज अ रेडियो एक्टिव आइसोटोप ऑफ आयोडीन 131 दैट इज टेकन अप एंड कंसनट्रेटेड सिलेक्टिवली बाय द थायरॉयड ग्लैंड. इन मोस्ट पीपल दिस स्मॉल डोज ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिविटी इज सफिशियंट टू ग्रेजुअली डिस्ट्रॉय द थायरॉयड टिश्यू ओवर 6 weeks to 6 months following a single dose. Patient with Graves disease have a high rate of permanent thyroid underactivity following radioiodine, whereas patients with nodular thyroid overactivity tend to preserve their thyroid function better, with only around half eventually becoming underactive. Patients are monitored for underactivity following the dose and promptly treated with thyroxine should this develop. The common outcome of thyroid underactivity is an accepted consequence of radioiodine therapy because hyperthyroidism is a serious condition, whereas replacement treatment with levothyroxine is simple and has no side effects at the correct dose. Radioiodine is a safe treatment for thyroid overactivity with no overall excess of cancers. Patient with ophthalmopathy require careful evaluation as radioactive iodine may worsen thyroid eye disease. This can be prevented by a short course of steroid tablets. There is no damage to fertility or to hair growth, but women are advised not to become pregnant for 6 months following a dose as the baby's thyroid could be damaged. Men should avoid fathering a child within 4 months of treatment. Following a standard dose of radioiodine, other precautions are necessary to minimize radiation exposure of others, but these restrictions are usually easily accommodated by the patient. Radioiodine may trigger airport security alarm up to 8 weeks following a dose, and patients should carry a letter about treatment if they travel in this period. Radioactive iodine is the most cost-effective and certain treatment for thyroid overactivity, and about 10,000 doses annually are given. Thyroid surgery. Surgery to remove most or all of the thyroid gland is another way of treating thyroid overactivity. This is a straightforward operation when carried out by an experienced thyroid surgeon with a low risk of complications. Hypothyroidism is a recognized side effect of surgery for which levothyroxine replacement will be needed. Lifelong. Thyroidectomy is a good treatment option for people with a large goiter and for those with thyroid eye disease. Prior to thyroid surgery, thyroid overactivity needs to be controlled, usually with antithyroid drugs, to make an anesthetic safe. This is because an anesthetic hyperthyroid person has a risk of precipitating a dangerous hyperthyroid crisis or thyrotoxic storm. Treatment of thyroiditis. Many forms of thyroiditis are self-limiting, meaning that the overactivity recovers spontaneously and no treatment may be required. If the person has severe symptoms of thyrotoxicosis, beta blockers are helpful. However, in some cases, thyroiditis can be painful or prolonged, and anti-inflammatory tablets or steroids may be helpful. Furthermore, in some cases, a period of thyroid underactivity may follow the thyrotoxicosis, and this may require levothyroxine treatment if causing severe symptoms. Module 7. pharmacokinetics of T4 and T3 and antithyroid drugs. All of the naturally occurring T4 and T3 exist in levo form. The dextro form of thyroxine has only 4% of the biological activity of the L isomer. Thyroxine is well absorbed from the duodenum and ileum when taken orally. Oral bioavailability of L-thyroxine is about 80% absorbed, while T3 is almost completely absorbed. T4 and T3 can also be given intravenously. In patients with hyperthyroidism, the clearance of T4 and T3 increases, and the opposite is true in hypothyroidism. Drugs that induce hepatic microsomal enzymes, example rifampicin, phenytoin, and phenobarbital, the metabolism of T4 and T3 and patient receiving T4 replacement therapy may require modification to maintain clinical effectiveness. If TBC binding sites are increased, there is an initial shift of the hormone from the free to bound state and decreases in the rate of elimination until the normal hormone concentration is restored. Thus, the total and bound hormone will increase, but the concentration of free hormone will remain normal. Thyroid preparation. These preparations are synthetic. Levothyroxine, liothyronine, antithyroid drugs, reduction of thyroid and hormone effects can be accomplished by agents that interfere with the production of thyroid hormones, by agents that modify the tissue responses to thyroid hormones, or by glandular destruction with radiation or surgery. The antithyroid compounds used clinically include the thiamides, iodides, and radioactive iodine. Module 8. Conclusion. The thyroid is a butterfly-shaped gland, typically weighing less than an ounce, that is located in the front of the neck just below the Adam's apple. It is wrapped around the trachea, and its purpose is to produce, store, and release into the bloodstream hormones that regulate or in some way participate in the process of a wide range of crucial bodily functions. The process begins when the pituitary gland, the so-called master gland, located at the base of the brain, produces thyroid-stimulating hormone, which acts upon the thyroid gland to produce two vital hormones, thyroxine and triiodothyronine, that influence virtually every cell in your body. Production of T4 and T3 occurs when iodine, introduced to the body via food, is synthesized. Although the thyroid produces much more T4 than T3, the T4 serves as the source of most T3, the form of thyroid hormone that actually enters the body's cell to maintain metabolic function by converting food into energy and heat. If the amount of thyroid hormone in the body is too low, the pituitary senses it and releases TSH, which signals the thyroid to produce more. Once the thyroid produces enough hormones for the body's needs, the pituitary slows down its production of TSH back to normal. The thyroid also produces calcitonin, a substance which regulates the body calcium levels by promoting absorption of calcium into the bones, while the importance of calcium in providing strong bones and teeth is well known. It also plays an essential role in brain function. When a chemical signal arrives at a brain cell, its the job of calcium to deliver that signal from the outside of the cell to the inside. With all this information, I hope you enjoy today's lecture. Keep on learning.